Hey guys, this is Austin. The PC versus Mac debate has been around forever, but how did things stack up 10 years later? Starting off, we've got the 2006 MacBook with the classic white design. Even though it's a decade old, it feels surprisingly modern. Build quality isn't as nice as modern aluminum Macs, but considering its age, this one is downright solid. You've got MagSafe for charging, which is still the best laptop charger ever, and things like the keyboard feels decent, if a bit mushy. The trackpad is still better than a lot of laptops today, with smooth two-finger scrolling, and it's got a decent variety of ports like USB, Ethernet, and a couple obscure ones like mini DVI and FireWire. The screen is respectable too, coming in at 13 inches with a resolution of 1280x800. It might be dated, but it's absolutely usable. On the PC side, we've got a 2006 Dell Latitude D620, and at first glance, it definitely looks its age. You'll notice the little things like the latch for the display, unlike the one-touch hinge from the MacBook, and a tiny trackpad with two options for the left and right click buttons. The keyboard feels a bit mushy, but it's still absolutely fine by today's standards. There are plenty of ports, a DVD drive, and a 14-inch screen, which is downright good. It's got an upgraded 1440x900 resolution, which wouldn't look all that out of place on a laptop these days. Windows XP has never looked so nice. One of the big advantages of PCs over Mac has typically been price, but let's see what you could get with your 2006 cash. The MacBook started at $1,100 with a 1.8 GHz Intel Core Duo processor, 512 MB of memory, and a 60 GB hard drive. The Dell D620 came with a slightly slower 1.6 GHz Core Duo, 0.5 GB of RAM, and a 40 GB hard drive for $50 more. However, this model was fully loaded, which puts the original price tag quite a bit higher than the MacBook. Today though, the Mac has held its value better, running around $150 compared to $100 for the Dell in 2016 cash. The big question though is how usable are these computers after 10 years? The MacBook has all the basics you need, like Wi-Fi and decent specs, which means it handles basic tasks like web browsing just fine. Since the newest OS it supports is Snow Leopard, a lot of apps aren't supported, but you can still download an up-to-date copy of Firefox to browse and watch YouTube. While the webcam on the MacBook might not be winning any awards, it is 480p, which just happens to match some other, slightly newer MacBook. The Dell originally shipped with Windows XP, which while 8 years older than Snow Leopard, is actually still fairly well supported today. Thanks to the more powerful Core 2 Duo, it's able to handle things even smoother than the MacBook. Web browsing and video is totally usable here. Neither laptop is equipped to do heavier lifting like video editing or gaming with the fairly anemic Intel GMA 950 graphics, but they've got everything you need to be a functional computer. I was curious though, with a few upgrades, how far can you push these laptops? I started with the MacBook, which is incredibly easy to upgrade. Just remove the battery and you can get at the memory, which I bumped up to 2 GB for $10 and installed a modern SSD. Give it a fresh copy of Snow Leopard and it's surprisingly snappy. The extra memory helps with lots of programs open and the SSD shrinks load times down to modern PC levels. When it comes to upgrading the Dell, it's a fairly involved process that requires some serious disassembly.
You looking for the hard drive?
Yeah.
Once you swap out the old hard drive for an SSD and install Windows 10, things are impressive. Basically everything works right out of the box, and the Core 2 Duo really isn't that far behind some of the lower end computers you can buy today. It might look a little weird, but with a simple hardware update and a fresh copy of Windows 10, you've got a solid laptop. When you look at price, it's a pretty clear win for the MacBook. Not only was it cheaper when new, but while used prices vary, Macs do a solid job of retaining value. Design-wise, it's also clear that Apple was ahead of the curve. The MacBook holds up well today, but one of the big advantages of a PC is being able to load a fully up-to-date copy of Windows 10. So after 10 years, which one would you go for? Let me know in the comments below and I will catch you. Oh shit, I gotta talk about Team Crispy Live. Pitch people Team Crispy Live right now.
I'm gonna be there.
Okay.
He's gonna be here co-hosting.
Apparently.
And I'll be the panel.
Ralphie will be the panel.
The supervisor.
I'm not gonna panel be able to use supervisor. Any of this. Team Crispy Live is a live show that we're going to be doing downtown LA on February 6th. So it's going to be myself, Jonathan Morrison, we've got Lou from Unbox Therapy, we got Marquez from MKBHD, and Judd from Your Average Consumer. So if you guys wanna come meet us, take a look at the show, we actually got a lot of really cool stuff planned. Definitely be sure to check out the link in the description. Tickets are like $6, so if you guys can make it, you should definitely come and hang out. Anyway guys, thank you so much for watching and I will catch you in the next one.